Welcome back to Green is Good, and we're so honored to have with us today Cliff Feigenbaum. He's the founder and managing editor of Green Money Journal and greenmoney.com. Welcome to Green is Good, Cliff.
Great to be here.
Hey, we're so excited and honored to have you on today. You're doing really important stuff. Before we get talking about your great brands, Green Money Journal and greenmoney.com, which, by the way, for our listeners out there, I'm on greenmoney.com right now. You can follow along as we speak with Cliff today. It's a great website, greenmoney.com. Before we get talking about all that, though, Cliff, talk a little bit about your story and your journey leading up to the founding of the Green Money Journal and greenmoney.com. How did you even get here?
Well, you know, I was learning about money in my life through watching my father go through a lot of financial, success, and then the opposite. And yeah. He ended up going bankrupt and dying of a heart attack at 46 of extreme financial stress. And it really taught me some lessons about looking at my own relationship with my money and my own financial thoughts and feelings. And so then, you know, I was working at a hospital in the Northwest, and I discovered, you know, I was trying to be more aware of my financial situation, and so I discovered that the 401k program that I had chosen some years before was full of mutual funds full of tobacco stocks. And I thought, for a healthcare institution, this is really inappropriate, and I don't want to profit from tobacco, and I don't want this in my portfolio. So it was really an awareness that if I'm having trouble making basic informed financial decisions, there's probably lots of people who are. And that's kind of how I ended up starting Green Money.
Wow. And how many years ago was that?
Boy, that was 1992.
Oh, my gosh. Wow. That's incredible. 1992.
Yeah, well, it's been a really incredible journey, as you call it. And we have felt very strong about people getting, you know, a stronger relationship, an understanding of what moves them about their money, what they're thinking about, what they want to do in the world. What do they want to profit from in their investments, and what don't they want to profit from? Really, to me, an important question that no one asked me when I got started, but it's part of our conversation, really, with our readers.
Wow, that's really, and I want to also mention, you know, and how did you and Bloomberg Press get together, and you wrote a book called Investing with Your Values, Making Money and Making a Difference. Share a little bit about that story and how that went, and how's that book going so far? And for our listeners out there, please go to Amazon.com, BarnesandNoble.com, or your local bookstore and buy Cliff's book. This is important stuff, everybody. How'd that happen?
Well, I had been publishing the Green Money Journal for about 5 years, and the phone rang, and it was Bloomberg Press, and they said, we've heard about you, we've heard about socially responsible investing, and we want to do a book about this. And I said, well, I'm not really sure that we can work together, because you believe just in profits, and we believe in principles and profits. And they said, no, we see this coming. We really want to be on the forefront. We know you're a leader. We won't hardly edit the book at all, because you know more about this than us. So we really, really want you to do this. And so that was in 1997. And it was a great honor to have a Wall Street firm, you know, acknowledge sustainable investing, socially responsible investing in this way. And so the book came out in 1999, so it's not available right now because it's passed, long since passed, but a friend of mine is actually writing the second, who co-wrote the book with me, is writing a book called The Resilient Investor, and that's coming out in January, so that's going to be a kind of a part two to what we were writing back, because every chapter that we wrote in the book, the different aspects of green investing and sustainable investing, became so big and so expansive that each chapter became, you know, could become its own book. And so it was It was a very exciting and very interesting time, but it, each of us who wrote the book, I wrote it with two other folks, Hal and Jack Brill, and we all just, our businesses just blossomed after that, and they manage money, and so we never got back all together to write another book, but it was really quite a thing to go to Bloomberg headquarters and everything and launch the book.
That is great. And so, you know, for our listeners out there, again, go to Cliff's great website, www.greenmoney.com. I'm on it now. It has so much amazing information. And that's important for all of it, everybody out there who's managing their own household income and their own finances and trying to make a future for themselves. Talk a little bit about what are the different elements of green and sustainable investing, Cliff?
Well, there's really three parts to this, and I really wanted to say that people who are managing their own investments, or if they have a financial advisor, planner, money manager, they need to know about this, because they need to know about people's values and what they want to profit from and what they don't want to profit from. And so the three aspects to sustainable investing, which is kind of the second part of what started as socially responsible investing, has kind of morphed into and grown and matured into sustainable investing. And the first part of that is where you kind of look at screening out things. What don't you want to profit from? For me, it might be tobacco, alcohol, gambling, weapons, slave labor, things like that. For me, I don't want to profit from. On the flip side, you look at what do you want to profit from? What company, what business practices do you want to make money from? For me, it's renewable energy. It's organic and natural foods. And those industries are doing really well. And I think those are, you know, leading to a more sustainable, green future. And I mean green as both environmentally as well as in my wallet. The third aspect is shareholder activism, whereas through the socially responsible sustainable mutual funds that are out there, they vote your shares in a more responsible way that can influence corporate behavior and influence boards in a way that, again, is more sustainable for our future, is more sustainable for the bottom line, because all of these things that we're talking about are bottom line issues. The well-being of your workforce, the well-being of the, you know, what you're putting out there as a product, what are you creating in the world, and is it healthy? Is it, you know, good for the environment? If it's not, you shouldn't be doing it.
How is it different from socially responsible investing, Cliff? I get confused. Social responsible sometimes is interchanged with green and sustainable. How do you differentiate those terms?
Well, sustainable is much less about social issues. And it's much less about what not to do. It's much more, sustainable investing is much more about investing in a positive future. What are the good companies to invest in? So that's more, so it's more on the positive side of the investing curve than the negative, just staying away from bad companies. So that's one of the major differences. And the other part of sustainable investing that I really like is called community or impact investing, where you invest locally in banks and credit unions, loan funds that are in your own state or in your own community or even internationally. Calvert Foundation is one of those that's really been a leader in this area, and so it's something I actually wrote the chapter in the book on community investing, and so it's something that we talk a lot about. How do you have more of an impact with your money in your own community? And I can give you an example of here in Santa Fe, New Mexico, where I live. We have something called the HomeWise Investment Fund, which helps people understand how to get their economics, their family economics, in line to be able to buy a house, get their credit in order, understand what's happening in their financial lives, and really, so they have to go through a lot of financial literacy before they qualify for a HomeWise home. And so it's a really great program, and you and they have investment notes. So it's something that I personally invest in, and it happens to be here in my own community, which I really like to be able to support, not just mutual funds that are on Wall Street, but how do I have an impact in my own city?
That's so interesting, investing locally like that. That is, so, you know, you cover, your website, again, is just amazing. I'm just entranced with it while I'm talking with you here. www.greenmoney.com. You talk about everything from investing to shopping. Why that kind of range? Why isn't it just straight blocking and tackling, investing, return on investment, and things like that? Why do you branch out into these different issues, Cliff? Why is that important, holistically speaking?
We wanted to really talk to people about where their money interfaces with the world. And everybody shops. Everybody goes to the grocery store. Not everybody invests. Maybe they invest a little bit. Maybe they can only afford a Pax World fund that starts at $250. Maybe some of our other listeners are, you know, have $100,000 or more to invest. So we really try and speak to everybody, because that we have a little something for everybody, I believe. And so we don't manage money, we manage information. And that's always been Green Money's focus, is to help people understand about their relationship with their money, where is it going, who are they supporting, because they can really make a difference with their shopping dollars. It's 70% of our economy is based on shopping and consumer. So you can really shift companies by where you put your money, who you support. I, you know, happen to be a big supporter of Whole Foods, and so I shop there and invest in the stock, which for me is an exciting way to do both. So it's something that, in fact, our newest issue is on sustainable agriculture and organics, because that's a topic that really matters a lot to a lot of people, and a growing amount of people.
Share a little bit about that. Share about the June issue talking about sustainable ag and organics. Share a little bit more about why is that important, why does that affect really so many of us, maybe all of our listeners?
Well, I've really liked organics and sustainable agriculture for a long time as an investor and as a shopper, because it affects our economy on so many different levels, from, you know, even the environment to the farmer, to the, you know, not using as many chemicals, to farm worker health, to our own personal health, to animal welfare. It has so many different aspects that we can, you know, align with. If we want to be more aware of our personal health, I really feel that you know, supporting and my own personal health through buying organics is part of my healthcare plan.
Got it. I see what you mean. Cliff, why is it important to be, for people to become aware of what business practices and products and investments they are willing to profit from and what are they not willing? You've given some great examples in terms of, you know, guns and tobacco and alcohol, and you've given another great example on the other side of Whole Foods. Talk a little bit about how you deal with people emotionally and how you help guide them to become conscious investors and more conscious with regards to their interrelationship with money.
Well, I think one good example of that is, like, right now Monsanto is a company that's very controversial. So you know, it's in the GMOs. And so does somebody believe that genetically modified organisms and GMO food is good for the world or not good for the world? So they can invest, you know, maybe Monsanto's in their portfolio, in their mutual fund, and they don't even know it yet. Or, you know, just going and buying organics, make sure that you are not buying anything that's a GMO. So to me, that's just a real quick thought. But for me, the idea of asking yourself, what do I want to profit from and what don't I want to profit from, is really, money is an individual decision about how we spend it, how we invest it, how we manage it, and just really getting clear about that. and asking yourself, it doesn't happen all at once. It didn't happen all at once for me. It was really, this continues to be an evolution and for me personally as well. I write about things and bring in writers and topics that I care about, that I see as the next edge that people need to pay attention to. And so we write it in a very inviting yet challenging way. We really are so well connected after 20 years that if we invite somebody to write on a topic, we pretty much get them to say yes. And the reason, I'll just say, that we approached especially the organics industry, is now a $35 billion industry. So 25% of the carrots sold in America are now organic, even at a Safeway.
Wow.
And normal grocery stores. So it's an expanding marketplace, and that's where, you know, we want to be.
You know, we've got about 4 minutes left, and you just brought up a great topic. You just said the next edge. I see in July that your topic is the next generation of sustainability leaders. Same thing as the next edge, I mean, in many ways. What do you see as the next edge of industry? What are the mega trends? And who are the leaders that are going to take us there? We got about 4 minutes left, so I'd love you to share with our listeners your crystal ball on the future of sustainability investing.
Well, it is an exciting issue for me. In fact, I've actually asked a guest editor to invite his young, up-and-coming friends who are really moving forward in the sustainable investing and business world. And so I can't give away too much, but I have to tell you, this is going to be one that people want to read. I'm excited. In fact, later this week, I get the new articles in. And so it will be on the website, greenmoney.com. The July issue will be up there, as well as people can sign up for our e-journal for free, and so they can read this issue. But I you know, people like Elon Musk of Tesla and SpaceX, to me, is very fascinating, and Jeff Bezos of Amazon. You know, there's really, really interesting people out there doing interesting things. I can't keep up anymore. I am so excited that sustainability has just exploded, has just blossomed so much. I'm paying attention to local food and the local food movement as well. I think that's a key part of sustainability, is understanding where our food and our water comes from, because those are essential to our life, and having that supply and clean water and clean food, that's a sustainability edge that not only can we look for, but we can invest in. And I think that sustainability should be the kind of companies that make money, and not just companies doing bad things making money. So that's transformation that I see.
Yeah, we're down to a minute or so. Any last thoughts for our investors out there who feel that it's hopeless, that they've blown too much money already? Any last thoughts on how to turn it around, and that it's never too late to turn around their finances and become conscious investors?
Well, you can start really small. And also, I don't want this to intimidate people that there's actually a mutual fund company out there that has kept their initial investment of $250 the same since 1970. It's the Pax World Fund. They've got great returns. They've got a great family of funds, that even emerging markets, green technology funds, as well as their Pax World Balance Fund. It's where I suggest everybody to start, because it's a low minimum. It creates an avenue for your wealth to go to and be created. So that's one of my suggestions.
Awesome.
And I look forward to anybody asking a question of me. They can email me at cliff@greenmoney.com as well.
Oh, that's wonderful. And you can subscribe to Cliff's great, great newsletter at www.greenmoney.com. Just hit the subscribe here button and get with it. Become a conscious investor. Thank you, Cliff, for being a financial and sustainability investment evangelist and leader. You are truly living proof that green is good.